Good morning, everyone. I'm going to go over the new Amen and the new Lamb of God that we will be putting into the Mass this morning. So here is the new Amen. It goes like this.
Good morning. Welcome to St. Michael's Catholic Church. Please silence your cell phones before celebration. Our opening hymn this morning is number 395 in the Blue Book, O Come, Emmanuel. Please stand.
Oh, come, Emmanuel. So we rejoice to gather in God's name once again as we begin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
We
welcome all our visitors to Tybee. Thank you for worshiping with us here at St. Michael's this morning. To prepare ourselves to truly rejoice in God's love, let us call to mind our sins and ask for God's pardon, God's peace. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, in our love for one another, you show us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
As you place before the Lord your own prayers and intentions, please join with me as I offer this Mass for the intentions of Father Dan O'Connell. Let us pray. Lord, pour forth, we beseech you, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, "Ask for a sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as the nether world or high as the sky." But Ahaz answered, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David. It is not enough for you to weary people. Must you also weary my God? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel." The word of the Lord.
And turn. He is the
From the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Paul, a slave of Christ Jesus, called to be an apostle and set apart for the gospel of God, which he promised previously through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures. The gospel about his son descended from David according to the flesh, but established as son of God in power, according to the spirit of holiness, through resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him we have received the grace of apostleship to bring about the obedience of faith for the sake of his name among all the Gentiles, among who are you also who are called to belong to Jesus Christ. To all the beloved of God in Rome, called to be holy, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Matthew. This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. When his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home. For it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. "Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, And they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took his wife into his home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
One of my favorite Advent traditions is to wrap gifts while watching It's a Wonderful Life. I'm a romantic, so I love the old-fashioned virtues of this film. Virtues like sacrifice and love of neighbor and a sense of duty and loyalty, which trump personal ambition and a desire for material gain. For those not familiar with the movie, the basic plot is that an angel is sent from heaven to help a desperately frustrated businessman by showing him what life would be like if he had never existed. And it was pretty grim. When I was watching it on Thursday night, the movie's strong undercurrent of faith really struck me. It unfolds in an America where religion and simple piety were taken for granted. I was moved once again to see the Martini family when they're moving into a new home, which was bought with a low-cost loan financed by George Bailey, the Jimmy Stewart character in the film. And what do these humble Italian immigrants do? As they're going into the house, they quickly sign themselves, make the sign of the cross, in a prayer of gratitude for being able to have this home of their own. Frank Capra, the director, was himself an Italian immigrant and Catholic. And no doubt he had seen that same scene in his own life. And in 1946, felt that it was pretty natural and normal to put it in the film. The movie reminds us of how one life can make a difference in the world. And when I was watching it the other night, I noticed something that I had never noticed before in the several times that I had watched it. The first name that is mentioned after the credits in the movie is George Bailey. But the second name is Saint Joseph. Saint Joseph is invoked in a special prayer at the beginning of the movie. And from that moment on, It's a Wonderful Life becomes like the gospel we just heard, the story of a righteous man and an angel. It's a parable of sacrifice and self-denial, of generosity and love. George Bailey gives up his own dreams to fulfill a greater dream, to fulfill a greater calling, to provide for others. When you think about it, this isn't that different from the story of the righteous man in the gospel, Saint Joseph. Reflecting on all this the last couple days, I wondered if Saint Joseph ever knew, like George Bailey, the frustrations, the anger, and temptations of life. No doubt he did. He was human, after all. He was flawed. He was probably prone to doubt and anger and selfishness and sin, just like all of us. Certainly, Saint Joseph must have had his share of confusion and anxiety when told of Mary's pregnancy. In that time, in that society, The consequences of a woman who was betrothed being found to be pregnant was serious. Even today, there are so-called honor killings in the Middle East. Joseph knew it could all have a fatal ending for Mary and her unborn child. So he decided to divorce her quietly, hoping that no harm would come to her. But before St. Joseph could put his plan into action, he heard the voice, a voice of an angel that came to him in a dream. An angel of God said to him, "Do not be afraid. Follow God's plan. God is with us." And trusting in this voice from God, St. Joseph's world and ours changed forever. In the middle of his anxiety comes a simple call to trust God's plan and a reminder that God's will sees beyond our anxieties, beyond our imperfect world. Our calling today is to trust in the promise of God and not be afraid. Do not be afraid of this imperfect world. Do not be afraid of the imperfections in your own life. If it's not done now, you might not have a perfect Christmas, but you still can have a Christmas full of love. Do not be afraid, for God is with us. He is Emmanuel. Do not be afraid of the ordinary trials and tribulations of life. Do not be afraid. God is with us. And as a Catholic people, we experience that presence through word and sacrament. And when we entrust ourselves to that experience, it is then that we can move beyond our own anxieties, beyond ourselves, to that experience where God stands with us, and that we can live out the values of God's kingdom more fully and not be afraid to take action on behalf of those who are in need, on behalf of those who might be rejected, on behalf of the suffering. Again and again, when we reach out, we find Christ in the reaching out. And the words come to us from this gospel in times of confusion and anxiety, are words that we need to hold on to. Do not be afraid. God is with us. It's a wonderful message to Joseph, to Mary, to the shepherds, to all of us in these final days of Advent. In these last days of Advent, as we light the fourth candle on the Advent wreath, as we sing, O come, Emmanuel, hopefully for us, the light grows brighter as we have that sense that God's presence is near. In the end, the words of the angel echo down to us as the great defining message of Advent hope, easing our anxieties about an imperfect world. Do not be afraid. God is with us. If we let those words sink into our hearts, into our souls, then truly it will be a wonderful life. Amen. This afternoon, from 2 to 4, the Holy Name Society is hosting a children's Christmas party. And that's going to take place on Jones Avenue in the All Saints Episcopal Parish Hall. And as busy as he is, this amazes me, I think Santa's going to be there. So there'll be arts and crafts and refreshments as well. So bring your children, your grandchildren, your nieces, and nephews. That's from 2 to 4 today. The office will be closed from Tuesday, December 24th, Christmas Eve, through January 1st, New Year's. It will reopen on Thursday, January 2nd. And we're gearing up for family promise to come to the island once again. This is a wonderful ecumenical program where we try to help two or three families get back on their feet from homelessness. We provide shelter and training and try to get them jobs and ultimately a place, permanent place to stay. So we need volunteers for that week from January 12th through the 19th. Volunteers to serve as dinner hosts, as evening hosts, and as overnight hosts. For more information or to sign up, see this woman right here, Joanne Naylor, and she'll be happy to place you as a volunteer in that wonderful program. Christmas Eve, our first Mass Christmas Eve is at 4 p.m. It's a Mass everybody wants to go to, so we're going to have a children's pageant during that, and that's a wonderful way to begin the celebration of Christmas. But we also have a quieter, more gentle 6 p.m. Mass, which will be a little easier to find seats at. So you have 4 or 6 o'clock on Tuesday, Christmas Eve, 10 a.m. on Christmas Day. And I'm happy to see that that tradition of going to Mass on Christmas itself is coming back, and that's wonderful. So hopefully some of you will be here on Christmas morning at 10 a.m. And do invite family or friends who may not be regulars, and offer a bribe to them. You know, tell them you'll take them out for a good meal afterwards. As people of faith, we stand to profess our faith in and through the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. For those who are visiting in the diocese, the vocation prayers that we use during our general intercessions are found on the inside back cover of the hymnal. Trusting in God's great love for us all, we place before the Lord these prayers and intentions.
For the church, that we, like Saint Joseph, may not be afraid to give ourselves wholeheartedly to the God who is always with us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are having an unplanned pregnancy, that they may honor the gift of life entrusted to them and draw strength from God to love and nurture their child, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to stay focused on God's presence in the midst of holiday distraction, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of all our visitors to Tybee and for protection from the disastrous effects of hurricanes and storms, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who need our support, especially the poor, the sick, the dying, and those who care for them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For vocations, we pray. O God, hear our prayer, and let our cry come unto you.
Bless our diocese of Savannah with many vocations to the priesthood, the diaconate, and religious life. Give the men and women you call alike to understand your gift, and the love to follow always in the footsteps of your priestly Son. Amen.
For those who have died, especially Marilyn Powers, and for their families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we rejoice in your love. Lead us ever deeper into the mystery of your presence through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory song is Hail Mary, Gentle Woman, number 889.
Teach us wisdom.
Sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory John, our Bishop, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord, deliver us from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other some signs of God's peace. Supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you trust you and obey. When your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I'll agree, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes. Yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. Yes.
Let us pray. Almighty God, having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray that as the feast of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Our children's Christmas party this afternoon at 2 o'clock. Mass on Tuesday evening at 4 and 6, on Christmas morning at 10 a.m. Again, we are thrilled that our visitors have come to worship with us this morning. The blessing that we use at the end of Mass can be found on the inside front cover of the hymnal. I pray it over you, and then you echo it back to me. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the blessing of God be upon you. The blessing of the Father and the Son, and may the Spirit of God, the Spirit of love, be with you all your days.
May the blessing of God be upon you, the blessing of the Father and the Son, and may the Spirit of God, the Spirit of love, be with you all your days.
This Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is "I'll Be Somewhere Listening for My Name." Music is in the pew. When he calls me, I will answer. When he calls me, I will. Listening for my name.